So we can technically use the mean integrated square error, or AMIS, to select the optimal bandwidth for a kernel density estimation. However, for general kernels, this is very difficult to estimate. So the first rule of thumb is given by Silverman's rule of thumb. This works only for one-dimensional data. The optimal bandwidth is given by H, which is 4 times sigma raised to the power of 5 divided by 3n, the entire thing to the 1/5 power. In this case, sigma is the standard deviation of the distribution. In this case, the kernel is also assumed to be Gaussian. A more generalized way to obtain a bandwidth is given by Scott's rule. This shows you the formula to obtain the general bandwidth in d dimensions. For one dimensional case, we put d equals 1. In this case, the sigma here shows the covariance matrix in the d dimensions of the data. In fact, when we determine the kernel density estimate of our data here, we used the Scott's rule to find our bandwidth. All the different factors we obtained were simply some fraction of the bandwidth obtained using Scott's rule. Notice we also used the Gaussian kernel here to get the KDE.